In the equilibrium topic, there are two main calculations you will have to do, the first of which is determining Kc from equilibrium constants, the second of which is calculating the quantities and concentrations present at equilibrium. Consider this a worked example for the first type of equation. N2O2 and NO2 exist in equilibrium in a closed system with a volume of 2.00 decimeters cubed. At equilibrium, 0.4 moles of N2O4 and 3.20 moles of NO2 are present. Calculate Kc. Now the first thing you should be noticing in this equation is that it's not as straightforward as it may seem because you're not given the concentrations of the reactants. You are given the moles and the volume, so you need to calculate the concentrations. Here I've simply divided the number of moles by the volume of the container to give the concentrations of N2O4 and NO2, which are 0.2 moles per decimeter cubed and 0.160 moles per decimeter cubed, respectively. Next thing we have to do is to define the equilibrium law for this reaction. So we know that it's products over reactants, and the products are two NO2 molecules. So we have the concentration of NO2 raised to the power of 2, because there's two of them, over the concentration of N2O2. Now by this point we have the equilibrium law and both of the concentrations at equilibrium, so we can substitute them into the equilibrium law to yield Kc. In this case it'd be 0.16 squared over 0.2, which equals 1.28. We can work out the units of Kc by cancelling out the repeated moles per decimeter cubed, so on the bottom, on the top, and on the bottom. So we're left with 1.28 moles per decimeter cubed. Take this as a worked example for the second type of calculation you're likely to come upon. 0.6 moles of hydrogen and 0.4 moles of iodine were mixed in a 1 decimeter cubed closed system. This mixture was allowed to reach equilibrium and 0.28 moles of hydrogen remained. Note here the equilibrium formula. You'll generally be presented with this data in the form of a table, so we can see that we've got the information from the question here, which I'll underline in pink, just so you can differentiate between what you've worked out. Now what you'll have to work out is the concentration of I2 and HI. And the way you do this is you work out the difference between this initial amount of H2 and the equilibrium amount of H2, because this is the amount in moles that have been used in the reaction. And because I2 and H2 both react with one molecule to form two molecules of HI, they have the same. So we can say that the I2 equilibrium concentration is as follows. 0.6. That looks more like a 6. 0.6 minus 0.28. So we can say the amount that's been used up in this reaction is 0.32 moles. So the equilibrium amount of I2 left over is 0.4 minus 0.32, which is 0.08. From the equation, we know that 1 mole of H2 and 1 mole of I2 will form 2 moles of HI. So we can say that 0.32 moles of change in H2 plus 0.32 moles of change in I2 will mean 0.64 change in HI. And because the size of the reaction vessel was 1 decimeter cubed, these values are also concentrations of I2 and HI, and H2.